technology should do the hard work so that people can get on with doing the things that make them happiest in life.
Google is on a mission to remove the technology from technology. With everything from music services to smartphones, their stated goal is to make the machine as intuitive, unnoticeable, and ubiquitous as possible. And their most controversial approach to do that is this.
It's the idea is that you feel like you've got the internet now just above your eye. In reality, it's not quite that, but it still opens up a lot of possibilities. Okay, Glass?
Luke Anea is a lucky guy. He runs an Australian startup called Safety Culture, looking to apply new technologies to workplace safety. And one of his US-based developers managed to get a hold of Glass. Now, there's only a few hundred of these in the world, and to the best of our knowledge, this is the only one in Australia.
I find it hard to believe that someone at Google or one of the senior engineers there hasn't got a pair for themselves, but we aren't aware of any others that are publicly available. When you first put it on, OK Glass appears on the screen along the time, so it's ready for you to give it commands. You have a touchpad on the side, which takes a little bit to get used to. You've got to sort of work out how sensitive it is. You want me just like this? I don't have to be wearing them?
Okie doke. I am ready to become a glass hole. All right.
Okay. Just pull them straight on, and you want it to sit just above your eye line.
Okay. Okay, so, every time I talk, it... Nice.
To give you a sense of what I'm seeing, we're streaming it back to Luke's phone. It's a fairly basic raft of functions. Google search, obviously. You can take photos, connect to Google Plus. Yes, they're still persisting with that.
We're going to have to become Google Plus friends.
For sure.
Which I'm sure is not at all Google's plan.
And of course, shoot video.
Okay, Glass. Record a video.
And now you're filming.
Yeah, now I'm filming you, filming me. Which is very meta.
The voice commands are about as good as something like Apple's Siri, which is to say it works 100% perfectly about 50% of the time. The interface, though, is freakishly simple to pick up. It sits just on top of your field of vision seamlessly. And your first thought is maps. Directions are clearly where this thing is going to be useful. But here's the thing. You know you look like an idiot, but after 15 minutes, you don't care. And that is both the best and worst element of Glass. It's so easy to pick up that you stop noticing it, but everyone else still does. It's the fear of looking like a dickhead that will be Glass's greatest challenge. Then, of course, there's the privacy issue. Google have promised to not allow any apps for Glass that will utilise facial recognition technology for the time being. It comes as local governments and retail outlets throughout the US have begun preemptively banning Glass because of fears of people being filmed without their knowledge. But the reality is that it's just not as easy to do that as you think.
You need to be staring wherever you're filming or wherever you're taking a photo, so you actually have to turn your head that way. And if someone's staring at you in the bathroom, whether they're wearing Google Glass or not, there's probably a greater issue, so.
This can go wrong in about 500 different ways. So tell me now, who wants to see a demo of Glass?
The real litmus test for Glass, though, is that initial moment you put it on. You look up to the right, and you instantly feel like this could change everything about the way you interact with technology. It's a bit like that first time you played with a touchscreen on a smartphone. It's that split second where you feel like a barrier has been dropped between you and the machine. Now, will Glass have as much impact as iPhones did? Well, to be honest, that depends on what developers like Luke build for it. But the potential is there, and if nothing else, Google have succeeded at removing the technology from technology.